island of trees. Koki and her grandmother were sitting on a string cot in the shade of an old jackfruit tree. And grandmother was talking about her father and his great love for trees and flowers. Grandmother said,
I was never able to get over the feeling that plants and trees loved my father with as much tenderness as he loved them. I was sitting beside him on the veranda steps one morning when I noticed the tendril of a creeping vine that was trailing near my feet. As we sat there in the soft winter sunshine, I saw the tendril moving very slowly away from me and towards my father. 20 minutes later, it had crossed the veranda steps and was touching my father's feet. There is probably a scientific explanation for the plant's behavior, something to do with light and warmth. But I like to think that it moved simply because it was fond of my father. Your great-grandfather had served many years in the Indian Forest Service. On his retirement, he built this bungalow on the outskirts of the town, planting the trees that you see around it now. There were other trees here before the house was built, including an old peepal which had forced its way through the walls of an old abandoned temple, knocking the bricks down with its vigorous growth.
What happened to the temple?
Asked Koki.
Well, my mother wanted the peepal tree cut down, but my father said he would save both the tree and the temple. So he rebuilt the temple around the tree, and there it is, on the other side of the wall. The tree protects the temple, and the temple protects the tree. People from these parts feel there's a friendly tree spirit dwelling there, and they bring offerings of flowers and leave them at the base of the tree. Your great-grandfather wasn't content with planting trees in the garden or near the house. During the monsoons, he would walk into the scrubland and beyond the riverbed, armed with cuttings and saplings, and he would plant them out there, hoping to create a forest. No one ever goes there, I said. Who will see your forest? We are not planting it for people to see, said my father. We are planting it for the earth and for the birds and animals who live on it and need more food and shelter. Father told me why mankind and not only wild creatures need trees. For keeping the desert away, for attracting rain, for preventing the banks of rivers from being washed away. But everywhere people are cutting down trees without planting new ones. The thought of a world without trees became a sort of nightmare for me. It's one reason why I shall never want to live on a treeless moon.
Zarra Nawazi ke liye shukriya.